Welcome back to CEEN Caribbean News. It is now time to go in depth. Last Thursday, the world celebrated the 33rd anniversary of World Food Day. The movement is spearheaded by the Food and Agriculture Organization, FAO. Indepth used the occasion to look at some of the issues affecting food security in the Caribbean.
On Thursday, as part of World Food Day, CARICOM turned its focus to food to underscore the serious issues affecting food security and cooperation between Caribbean governments. Food security is one of the Caribbean's main objectives as a part of the world's Millennium Development Goals. However, the region is not working together on the issues that underpin food security, according to Chairman of the Caribbean Farmers Association, Jamaican Senator Norman Grant.
For example, there are 500,000 farmers that I represent within CARICOM, but yet still there's not free movement within the region. You know, our farmers are not able to move from one country to the next and cultivate agriculture. We have a serious problem in terms of logistics as it relates to cargo of our food.
According to the chairman of the Caribbean Farmers Association, in current times, CARICOM is a paper tiger, empty of resolve. This is compounded by the fact that while CARICOM and the regional alliance is being touted, Caribbean countries are really driven by competition against each other. At this point, regional countries have an easier time trading with continents oceans away.
It is easier for me to get a container of coffee to Korea or to Japan or to China than to get, you know, a case of yam to Trinidad or St. Vincent.
About a year ago, Caribbean players met in Antigua and determined a way forward as it relates to cooperation on food security to ensure a unified approach. The Canadians are involved.
I was at the Quoted Agricultural meeting in Antigua a year ago, and we discussed the issue of logistics and transportation. And the governments of the region, we raised some $20 million through CEDA, that has now been implemented by the Canadian Hunger Foundation.
The Canadian International Development Agency, CEDA, has been co-opted to help CARICOM formulate a marketing system to help the region feed itself. It seems that the Caribbean is realizing that they have to address food security as a bloc. This link-up going forward, according to Senator Grant, should leverage each country's strengths as it relates to food security, agri-trade, and other issues of this nature.
So they have funded a program to the tune of $20 million to spearhead marketing in the region. And we were sitting down with the ministers of agriculture in the region. And as farmers' organization, they looked to us and says, can some of this money go towards the resolution of the transportation within the region? My position as chairman of the Caribbean Farmers Association was, we are expecting the governments of the region to resolve this, because I think that's why they are elected as government.
The Caribbean agricultural specialist did not mince words with Indepth. He says there is absolutely no reason why the Caribbean cannot unite on this very pertinent issue. Senator Grant says the region's governments are engaging in a lot of, quote, catwalking, end quote.
We need to really come together as a region, rather than seeing ourselves has been separated by the Caribbean Sea. We need to see ourselves as been joined by the Caribbean Sea. And there are a lot of self-interest in the process. And quite frankly, I think, you know, it's going to be controversial, but I think at this time, CARICOM lack decisive leadership. You know, in days gone by, you had, you know, like a P.J. Patterson, who really, Honorable P.J. Patterson, who really believed in the integration, you know, of CARICOM. You had the Prime Minister of Guyana, the President of Guyana, President Jagdeo. These are persons who really believed in CARICOM. And I think that the whole issue of the changing of governments on a regular basis within CARICOM has also affected the platform.
He explains the relevance of World Food Day as the Caribbean struggles to achieve full food security as a part of the Millennium Development Goals set by CARICOM.
The basic objective is really to push for agricultural production to get food security. It's a fight against food insecurity. 2 years ago, we had 1 billion people that were food insecure. There has been a major push by Jamaica, by the world, by the FAO, to engage bilateral, national discussions with countries and organizations and farmers to really mount a massive campaign to increase our food. That has been very successful because last year 100 million people became food secure. So the number now stands at about 805 million. And, you know, in keeping with our millennium goal, we're hoping that within a reasonable time, every single person on the globe will have safe food, secured food, and will have access to food.
Senator Grant identifies the family farmer as the paradigm to address world food security problems.
In terms of the celebration this year, the FAO has dedicated, in keeping with the United Nations, 2014 as the year for family farming. So it's about protecting family farming, increasing our production, and taking care of the hearth. And the family farming population in the world now stands, the farming population in the world now stands at about 570 million farmers. 500 million of those are family farmers. And it tells you how important family farming is to the development and the securing of our food.
The agricultural expert gave more details on what the global agenda is. He says this is an agenda with which the Caribbean has to align itself.
World Food Day, this is the 33rd anniversary, and in fact World Food Day was celebrated to commemorate the formation of the FAO and the
Food Agricultural Organization,
FAO. And quite frankly, the FAO then said, what is it that we should really do to celebrate the formation of this very important organization? And it says, let's focus on food for all our people. Family farming is where you have small families engage in agricultural production. Let's look on Jamaica, for example. We have, based on the census of 2007, some 228,000 farmers. 79% of those farmers are family farmers. And these are farmers who cultivate on land acreage approximately 2.5 acres. But they employ somewhere in the region of 6 persons. And it tells us how critical and important a role these farmers play.
Senator Grant lent some more clarity to family farming.
Family farming is critical to that process. That is why, from where the JA stands, we are intensifying our partnership with the Ministry of Agriculture and organizations such as FAO to intensify and expand rural development.
And that is it for In Depth. Sports is next on the other side of this break. Stay tuned.